Welcome, my dear student. In this video, I am going to tell you that how can you apply the goal-seek operation in any given scenario also. So, imagine that you are preparing a bill. In this bill, invoice amount is 10,000 and the service taxes is 9% and the estate taxes is 9%. So, we can assume that these taxes are the fixed taxes. You cannot make any changes in it because it is set by the government. So now by calculating these total amount is 11,800. You can see that here I had applied a formula in order to calculate the total based the cell B3, that is at this cell, plus 9% of the cell B3 and then again the 9% of the cell B3. So the total paid amount for the customer is, that is 11,800. And usually customer asks for the discount. So consider a situation in which the customer is asking for the discount and see the customer is saying that he will pay only 11,000 rupees. So what will be the total invoice amount? Means the CST and GST you cannot change because it is fixed. So the changes will be done in the invoice amount. So for this type of calculation, we use goal seek that we can found in the WhatUp analysis column. So to apply the goal seek in this formula, first click on the data tab. And in the data tab, you will have the WhatUp analysis tab, that is the highlighted you can see. And in when you click the drop down menu, you will find the option goal seek. When the goal seek tab will open, you will have the first column of that is asking for the set cell, means whose value you want to set. Just select the total cell and you will have the address of this cell here. Now the next parameter is to value, means the current value is 11,800 and at which value you want to set the cell. So as I told you earlier that I want to set the cell at 11,000. So write here 11,000. And after writing here 11,000, the next parameter is asking, that is by changing cell. So now in which cell you want to make the change? So as I told you that the GST and CST is the fixed amount or the fixed percentage of the invoice amount. So there is only one column in which you can make the changes. So select the this cell in order to make the changes. Now click on the OK button. And now you can see the total will 11,000 and the invoice amount is changed from 10,000 to 9,332. Means while making the total amount 11,000, you will have to make the changes in the invoice amount, that is 9,030. So in this type of situations, when you have the idea of the total amount and you know the result of the formula which you are applying and you just want to change the formula or the change the value of the formula by making a change in any different cell, so we can use the goal seek option from the WhatUp analysis page.